Hi everyone, today we're going to talk about L'Oreal's products that I found in my local store, and these are the Infallibles. They have two different lines. They have the regular Infallibles, total coverage, and there's also the paints. Let's first start talking about the paints. L'Oreal Infallible paints line has four items. The four products they came up with was the lip product, the eyeshadow, blush set, and eyeliner. Here you'll find three out of the four. The one I don't have is the eyeliner, but I do have the eyeshadows, which are these. I have 308 Aqua. I can't even say the other word. Ayura. And there's a 0.25 fluid ounces. And I also have 320 brown sugar. And it does have two different types of browns, a lighter brown and a darker brown. This has like an aqua color and like a, I want to say like a pinkish type of color. That's what it looks more like. But we'll talk about these in a little. Then we have the Infallible paint blush set. And it comes with four different colors and a brush. Then we also have the Infallible paints lips. And these are two different colors, 326 and 312, New Star and Sultry Sangria. I chose one of like the darker colors and one of the like the lightest within the range. They do have other colors. They do have like blues and all the different colors. They have a lot of nice colors. Now, let's go back to this. Let's go back to the eyeshadows. These eyeshadows, they're double ended. They look a lot like liquid lipsticks. They run for $8.99, and I haven't opened the brown one, and I'm not gonna open this. So I actually wanna pass that. But as you see, it's like a dolphin applicator. It's like that, and I'm gonna do a swatch here for you. See how that looks? And then I'm going to do a swatch of the other side too. You notice that that kind of bubbled up in the corner there. if you notice, I did use this, but look how ugly it's already starting to look. I use it for the purpose of trying it out and making sure that I knew, you know, how it actually worked, because I've never worked with this before. It's not like a... I just wanted to say that these here, I tried this one out, that one I haven't. This here, I can say that I like the fact that it has a nice, the applicator, is, you know, it has the applicator, it seems like it's a good idea, but the packaging is nice, you can just throw it in the bag and forget about it, it's nice and secure, so it's not going to spill or anything else. It's a good, like, the idea was great, but does it actually work? So I do like the packaging, like I said, and the applicator. The cons is that it's that when you put this on, this is supposed to be like a long-lasting formula. It does say that it's supposed to be long-lasting. It's supposed to be. Some people have used the lighter colors as bases, but it's not. You're supposed to be able to combine them, even put them on top of each other. But it's really hard to put on top of each other when one of them actually gives you more texture to your eyes. Like I noticed, like it actually kind of gave you texture. Like putting it the applicator, it wasn't like it gave you the best application. You actually needed to go in probably, and not with a brush either, with your finger, like smoothing it out and playing with it. And then once it kind of like dried some, then go in and start blending and doing the whole process. But they did blend pretty easily. I was actually surprised at the fact that they blended a lot easier than what I thought. But with that being said, you do not really want to put stuff in your eyes that I think the blue was a little bit more like gave you more texture than this. And this actually disappeared. Probably my skin color. That's why it does say apply one color, wait until that dries down and apply the second color. You know, that I guess they don't want you to put, of course, two. This is like a cream shadow. two creams and you start, then of course it's going to become muddy or stuff like that, especially when it's two browns. They wouldn't want you to do that. So that's my take on that. I'll insert some pictures so that way you can see. And the picture that you're looking at right now, you're seeing that the blue was used and so was the lighter color. Nothing else was used. There was a primer used before that. Next, we have the Infallible lip paints. Well, I'm going to, first of all, let me show you how these are. When I first saw these at the store, what they reminded me of was a bigger size of what they call the Color Yolt for Maybelline. Okay, Maybelline had this Color Yolts, which are right here. I actually have those. And they came with this, like, this type of applicator. See how messy it gets? Well, and that's what I thought it was going to be. Notice how this, and then you just pass it on. Well, I thought that's what this was going to be, but I was actually surprised with the way the applicator from that was, which is totally different from this. These actually have like a liquid lipstick. They have a doffer. They have this type of applicator, and I actually do like the applicator. Let me show you a swatch of this. Beautiful color, I must admit. Very well pigmented. That's the sangria color, and now this is the Nude Star. Another very nice color. Let me just get that a little bit bigger. Oops. Okay, I made that a little bit bigger so that way you can show better. So Nude Star and Sangria. Very nice. They look very pretty. They smell pretty good. I don't know what it is that they smell like, but they remind me of like a candy or something. They actually smell really sweet and good. For this. The pros are nice packaging, you know, very nice. Easy to throw in the purse and keep on going. Nice applicator. The cons. It slips. The cons about these are, number one, it slips everywhere. You end up with lipstick everywhere. When I mean everywhere, I mean it slips out of your lips and everything else. I tried them without a lip liner because I just wanted to try. I actually wanted to try them with and without. But I first went without and it was so bad. Both of them, they slipped out. I mean, I don't know if it's because I'm so used to using liquid lipstick, so I don't really have to worry about that. But it shouldn't be something that you have to worry about. You shouldn't have to worry about, oh my god, my lipstick is going to move or it's going to go outside my lip. It shouldn't be. And the lip liner didn't make much of a difference. So, personally, that was the biggest issue with these. And they do not last. This is something you have to keep on putting out throughout the day because they don't last. Obviously, they're not made for that either. They don't claim that they would last. Now these, on the other hand, it claims that they will last. And they did not last very much. They started getting patchy. And they did not last as long as it states, you know. It gives off the texture, like I said. But anyway, going now to the blush. I wanted to go here because this is... I don't know if I said the price of the lipsticks. The price for the lipsticks are $9.99 a piece. $8.99 for the eyeshadows. And this here, it's $16.99. This is the Infallible Paint. Still, it's still from that same line. It's the third product from the same line. And here we go. First thing you're going to see is that it comes with this brush. You can say goodbye to that because that does not work. Then we have four colors. Okay. We have four colors. These are all mattes. There's like the first one here, which is supposed to be a peach pink type of color. This is an orangey color. Then there's like the hot pink. And there's like a rosy medium pink here. These are intended to be worn either alone or to be worn on with as a combination. You can either put them together, all of them, or just like try two, or whichever way. It's nice for you to play around with. This is what this palette was intended for. Let me just give you swatches. Okay, swatches. This is like the peach pink. Doesn't really show on me. Orangey. Orange. The hot pink. And the medium rosy pink color. All four of them are there. Including the other swatches from the other stuff. Let's see if I can get a swatch. A better swatch of the first one. This is the first one and the orange one next to each other. First one. The light pink peachy color type of. And the orange. Again, look at these colors. Like I said, these are meant for them to be used together or used separately, whichever way you want. I just opened these and look at the way, just by the touching, how if you look closely, you can see all the powder there and stuff. So they are kind of powdery, and if you look at that first one, yeah, it is powdery, bit powdery. On the back, it does, you know, it's just a regular palette. On the back, it just shows you, you know, how you can use them. Now, we're going to go ahead and look at the other stuff that they put out there. The other stuff that L'Oreal put out there was the Infallible Total Color Correcting. There was a color correcting kit, and there's also a cover concealing and contour kit, which I don't have that one, but I do have the color correcting one, which is this right here. And if you look in the corner, it says Infallible Total Cover. And it has the four colors. And this is from the L'Oreal Infallibles. This just says under L'Oreal Infallible. This is $2.25. There's just one for everyone. And that's the same thing with the blush. It's intended for every skin tone. And I do think that these blushes could be used for most skin colors, you know? Especially that you can play around with them and put them together. The first one, it's the peach color. And that's intended for dark circles. The yellow, we know that that's for discolorations. And the green is to neutralize the redness. And the purple brightens the skin, and it takes away the dullness of the skin. And then it comes with this little sponge, which also it's not really good. And it's also a plastic. It's just like the other one. The palette is just like that. It's about the same thickness. Oh, on the back it says, disguises dark circles, combats discoloration, neutralizes redness, and brightens dullness. I have to play with these. See, these are the colors. And I just want to, I mean, there's no point of doing swatches. You're not going to, like, but it goes pretty smoothly onto the skin. I can say that. Pretty smooth into the skin. Do they work? I actually tried the one for the dark circles. I felt like it went into every single little fine line. Any little thing that I found, it actually went in there. But I only tried it once. I really can't judge it yet. I have to go ahead and play with it a little bit more. I have to play with these and see how they work out. If you notice, these are also intended for every skin color. Do I think they can be used for every skin color? Probably, because these are used under makeup. So yes, first one could be used on your eyelids, for example, and that gets covered anyway. And just for the, if you have any discoloration, like they say, for example, or you have dark circles, you can use it. And on top of that, you use your concealer. So yes. Now, another product that I wanted to talk about was the Infallible Pro Last Lip Color. The reason I wanted to mention these, even though these are not brand new, is because they are one of the lipsticks that I do like from the drugstore. They're a liquid lipstick that is non-transferable, stays pretty long. Yes, there is two steps to them, but I actually do like these. I actually enjoy these. I actually wear these. And I am going to go ahead and give you guys swatches and all that in another video, which should be coming up shortly. I should be trying to do that today. But these are $12.99, and you can find them at any drugstore. And I like them. I know I see a lot of not so great reviews about them, but everybody has their own opinion. Everybody has their own likes and dislikes. Anyway, going back to what we went up to today, we went through today. Today we spoke about the L'Oreal Infallible Paints. Infallible Paints eyeshadows. Will I buy these again? I don't know. They do have like different colors, which is one nice thing. They do have like they have like that subtle color, like that brown color, which is nice. But they also have like a yellow with, I think it's like a lighter color. So they do have like some intriguing colors that will be nice to check out to see how they work. And so yeah, maybe I'll grab one or two and check them out. And if I see that there's any difference, I will actually update this. But for now, I can say that the pros is the packaging is great. It's easy to carry around. They have a lot of nice colors. The cons is that they're patchy. They don't last as long as they're stated to say. They do give off some type of texture when you put them on your eyes. And I don't like that part. We also spoke about these. What happened with those was they actually run all over your lips. They don't last much. You have to be on top of the fact that you have lipstick on and reapplying. And I'm not a person that likes to reapply lipstick all day long. So I won't be buying any more of those. I really dislike those a lot. The next thing we looked at was the Infallible Blushes. I wouldn't repurchase this because it's going to take a very long time for me to finish these. If I don't know if I will get to use these a lot, but I will give them a try, obviously. And I have so many blushes that I probably won't be able to get through them. But it's nice to have. I mean, I like the fact that it has the orange color that is a little bit different. I mean, the only another con about this is it's not that big, the shade. You notice, so when you put a fat brush, it's gonna be really hard. You can go ahead and take from the other side. For example, I have the It Cosmetics blush brush, and that's pretty big, so I know it will probably cover part of the other one. So you have to be really careful when you go ahead and go into the product, because you don't, if you're just trying to do one color, you don't want the other color going into your brush. So keep that in mind. So keep in mind, these are $16.99. These are $8.99 and the lips are $9.99. These are also $16.99. This is the color correcting. Some people swear by the color correcting. Some other people say, eh, don't know. I have to play with these. I don't know. This is the color correcting that we spoke about. The color cover, total cover, infallible total cover, color correcting. I don't have the ones that are the concealers, and it's also the same way. It just has concealers and contour. So those are the products that I found in my nearby drugstore. I want to swatch this. And so do you own any of these products? Let me know if you do. And if you do, let me know what your thoughts are. I just want to say thank you so much for watching. Thanks for taking out the time. Don't forget to subscribe. And don't forget to look at my other videos. Mwah. Have a great day.